Okay, last time we solved the problem of finding the square root of 2 to 10 or 11 decimal places by hand. And you may be thinking, yeah, so what? I got a calculator that can do that. Show me something that I don't know how to do. Because we don't live in 1970, we live in 2012 or 13 or whatever year you're watching this. And so let's solve an equation that you can't do with a calculator. Let's solve the equation e to the x plus x equals 4. There is no key on a calculator that'll solve that equation for you. So what we're really trying to do is we're trying to solve e to the x plus x minus 4 is 0. So our function is f of x is e to the x plus x minus 4. And the derivative of that function is e to the x plus 1. And Newton's method says our new guess is going to be our old guess minus f of the old guess divided by f prime of the old guess. So let's make our table and see what we can do with that. So, first column of our table is our guesses, and then we'll put f of x, which in this case is e to the x plus x minus 4, and then f prime of x, which is e to the x plus 1, and then we'll want to figure out our new guess, which is our old guess, minus f of x divided by f prime of x. So if we start that with a guess of 1, 1's not too far off because e to the 1 is e, which is about 2.7, plus 1, that's 3.7. That's pretty close to 4. In fact, f of x winds up being minus 0.28171872. And in case you're wondering, yes, I am using a calculator to figure out these numbers. Our derivative winds up being 3.71821828. That's e plus 1. And then we just pull out our calculators and say 1 minus negative 0.27181872 divided by this number. And we wind up getting 1.0757656. I claim this is closer to the correct answer than this is. If we want to get something that's closer still, we figure out what f of that is, and that winds up being 0.08008056201. You plug this number into this function, you get 3.93223696202, and you turn the crank one more time. You take this minus this divided by this, and you get a better answer. You get 1.07373048307. You run everything through one more time. You take f of that, and you get something much smaller. You take f prime, it's 3.92627585, and the next answer is 1.0737289 3756, and that answer is actually good to 11 decimal places. If you plug in what f of this is, if you plug in this number over here, you take f of that, you get 0.00000000001. And then f prime will be about 3.9, and the difference will not affect the last decimal place. So, even if given a problem that you can't solve in closed form, there is no formula for the answer to this problem. But there's a way to get a good answer and turn it into a better answer, and turn that into a better answer, and turn that into an even better answer, that's good to 11 decimal places.